Welcome. In this video, we are going to see how to start with a simple presentation like this and create an interactive presentation from it using custom shows. Here we have one slide with all four topics shown. I run the presentation, I can click on any topic, show that topic, and it'll come back to the menu. In fact, if you have attended any of my sessions, this is the most famous slide. And each one of these icons is hyperlinked to a custom show. So I can go, show it, and come back. This is what makes the presentation dynamic, interactive, and flexible. To create these custom shows quickly, we need an add-in. So let's see how to download and install it. The download link is given in the description. Download the files. One is a sample file. One is a PPAM file, which is the add-in. If you want to learn the code behind it, you have to use the PPTM file. After downloading, right-click on each file, go to Properties and unblock them. The next step is to install the add-in. Go to PowerPoint, File menu, Options. Under Add-ins, look at the drop-down, open it and go to PowerPoint Add-ins. Click on the Go button and in this dialog, choose Add New. And then select the PPAM file. Enable that checkbox and click Close. Accept all the security related things like enable macros, enable content, and make this a trusted file. And then in the add-ins menu, you will see all the options we have built for you. In this video, we are going to see create custom shows option. To know what each button does, just look at the tooltip. Here is a summary of what each button does. Of course, we have separate videos for each one of them. I have created all these over the years along with my friend Raj Chaudhary. So let's see how to use this add-in. So let's start with the base presentation. I have four topics: Word, Excel, PowerPoint, and Copilot. And of course, there's a summary area. So what I want is a menu which can traverse only Word, only Excel, and so on. In order to do that, I need custom shows. Now, making custom shows manually is laborious. So we are going to do it in a different way. First, I'm going to create sections. Sections, you create one by one by right-click and add section. But I'm not going to do that. I'm going to use another tool called Insert Zoom, Summary Zoom. And now select all the slides where a new topic starts. Wherever I selected, it has added a section. PowerPoint added one more section called summary section, and it actually created a menu for me, which is out of the box and the simplest way to create an interactive presentation. If this serves your purpose, you don't need the add-in at all. But in my case, I want custom menus. That's why I wanted to use a different approach. So I'm going to delete this slide and add my own version of that menu. I want to hyperlink this to these sections. And you cannot create a hyperlink to sections. So if I go to hyperlink, so I can go to place in the document, choose the word slide and hyperlink. But that's just a one-way street. After I finish all the word slides, it's not going to come back. There is a show and return option, but that works only with custom shows. But we don't have any custom shows. That's the problem. Whatever is in the section is exactly what I want as a part of the custom show. That is why I created this add-in. Go to our add-in and click on Create Custom Shows. We have seven sections, so it creates seven custom shows. And now that we have custom shows, I can go to hyperlink, Control K, place in the document. Now you will see all custom shows. I'm going to select section one, which is Word. Remember to enable this checkbox, show and return, and then repeat the process for Excel, PowerPoint, and Copilot. And now I can run this presentation. Wherever I click, it'll go show those slides and come back to the menu. So it's similar to Insert Zoom, but this gives me much more direct control. And as you know, hyperlink works with text, shape, any object really. So custom show approach gives you much more flexibility. Custom shows do not update automatically. That's why when you make changes to the presentation, run this create custom show again so that all the shows are updated. To see all the custom shows and manage them, go to slideshow menu, custom slideshow, custom shows. This will show you a list and you can modify them and remove them. In case you want to remove all of them, you can go to the add-in and choose delete custom shows. This will ask you to confirm and then delete all custom shows. If you find this or any other button useful, then you're going to use it frequently. So what do? Right click on the button which you know you're going to use frequently. In this case, our create custom shows button. Click on add to quick access toolbar. Where does this go? It'll go here. And now it doesn't matter which menu you are in one click, your button will run. In fact, if you press the Alt key, it got the number 6. So Alt 6 downwards is going to run this macro. All the frequently used buttons you should add to quick access toolbar. And if it becomes too long, right click on it and say show it below the ribbon so that it doesn't interfere with your file name. I help customers globally to create high impact presentations. My email ID is in the description. Let's connect and grow together. Thank you for watching. Try this out and let me know your feedback. Share it with your friends and colleagues. Subscribe to learn and grow. That's all for now. See you next time.